Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Status Report highlight for the 27th of February, 2018. We're going to kick things straight off, but every time I try to highlight these, I just have to cover all the information. This is a pretty good one, so let's get started. Kicking things off with lead producer Eugen and the progress made on some features over the last 2 weeks. Ladders. Mentioned before a million times, it's finally working and ladders are done on the player side. We're converting data for all buildings and working on sounds for ladders. Swimming. Again, something that has been missing from the basic movements of the new character for a long time, and it's merged in and done now. As is the case with the ladders, sounds are the last thing being added at the moment. Unconscious state. We're currently at the beginning of polishing phase of all animations and data, and looking into connecting the state with character representation and shock values. Damage system. Bleeding, penetration, and ballistics. After merging in our first working implementation of the new damage system, we're finally working on tweaking the damage values and states. Penetration and ballistics, looking to polish it for experimental release. Bleeding has been connected to the system as well and is working already. We are fighting issues with particles and blood and trying to find a good visual solution. Ooh, those new particle blood effects I am looking forward to. Something I know a lot of you are pretty excited for, jumping, climbing, and bug fixing. Since swimming and ladders are working technology-wise, we have moved on to the proposed jump and climb mechanic. Jump is going to get in first, and climbing, as it is quite complex, is definitely going to require a lot more polish. Stability. The QA team has just got back to work on the build stability. Our stability has been pretty bad recently, with all the large features getting in, so most of our team is focused on bug fixing and it has paid off already. We're definitely not done, and there is still tons of crashes to fix, but the stability has increased by a factor of 30 in just the last 2 weeks, and I look forward to a normal play session in 0.63 experimental release candidate. User actions. Because anything you do in-game is working through user actions, we are getting the proper animations in, making sure that the base survival mechanics work and that there is a loop to follow when you get into the game. It makes the gameplay much smoother. Weapons. Work on weapons has slowed down because some of our team members were traveling, and also because we wanted to get in more of the melee combat animations. With the last changes in heavy and light attacks, the guys from our animations team are in general working on making sure both one-handed and two-handed attacks are polished and ready to use. Player turns and prone. We're looking into what's next for all the amazing features that the new animation system has brought us and polishing them, trying to fix both functional and visual issues that arise from the fancy and cool prone combat. Refactor of infected. Since a lot of work on the player is getting done, our lead programmer Mirik is heavily focused on a refactor of the infected, both in terms of stealth and combat. We don't want to promise anything, but we should hopefully be seeing the results soon, and build advanced features for the infected in quick succession after the basics of the work are merged in and working reliably. Collision issues. Not much has changed here since the last status report. There is a huge pass on all objects in the game in terms of collision for both gameplay reasons, camera, and much more. And since there are hundreds if not thousands of objects, depending on how you count some, this is definitely a long-term task. Eugen is very happy with the progress he's seeing and can't wait to play with us sooner than you think. Wink, wink. Try not to get too excited though, guys. It's only 6-3. And now let's move on to everybody's true hero, lead designer, Peter Nespezny. On screen now we can see a clip of the video, link in the description to the full video, of the animations for climbing up and down with normal speed, as well as a quick scale up and fast slide down. Also note that climbing the ladder is being shown on a one long, continuous, seamless ladder, with the possibility to exit and enter the ladder on accessible levels in the middle of the tower. Ladders have been quite a concern for some time for players. I know this, I hear it all the time, so I'm looking forward to the improvements. And I do like sliding down ladders in games, makes you feel pretty cool. And now let's move on to something pretty interesting, the ongoing work being done with the new damage system and ballistics. In the new damage system, we are using hit zones, which are defined by meshes, that allows us to properly depict shapes of every desired component, leading to accurate hit detection and allowing us to incorporate terminal ballistics or projectiles to calculate the proper damage that should be applied. DayZ is an authentic game, and I'm convinced the range combat should definitely underline this direction. Hit zones obviously correspond with basic individual parts of characters' body, such as feet, legs, hands, arm, torso, and head. There are also additional hit zones for vital organs, brain, heart, spine, lungs, and liver, to deepen the representation of the character body. In real life, damage dealt by projectiles to the human body is very complicated, and it's fairly impossible to simulate in-game. So some necessary simplification is in place. Each hit zone has its own health, which may or may not affect the global health of the character, as well as optional vital attributes. A player character cannot directly die just by shooting its limbs. Our goal here is to avoid unreliable situations like shooting the character 10 times in its feet in order for it to get killed. However, as projectile's penetration leads to bleeding wounds, the character will die indirectly by bleeding out without a treatment. Also, limbs can be fractured if their health falls down to zero, leading to restriction in character movement unless treated by attaching a splint to the fractured limb, which will heal it over time. On the other hand, damage to the torso and head can lead to direct death, global health at zero, as well as indirect death by bleeding out. Vital organs have relatively low health, and destroying them leads basically to instant direct death, which opens a way to encourage shot placement in combination with ammunition used, depending on the current situation. Peter then goes on to say this is going to be a hard thing to balance, but it should be a very good thing for PvP in DayZ. As all of you should know by now, there are some very random moments in 0.62, where you could get shot in the toes once and die, or you shoot somebody else 10 times in the chest and they seem to survive. Hopefully, this will solve that issue, as it can be very frustrating. Of course, do expect bugs and it not to be finished in 0.63 experimental at least, but it should be a massive improvement to PvP. As from what this says, we should be able to shoot somebody where we expect them to die straight away, whereas a shot to the leg or an arm would cause them to limp away and have a much more realistic PvP experience. In summary on this subject, you're going to have to be a lot more careful with your shots. Make them count. Now let's move on to your boy that makes Chernarus live and breathe, map designer Adam. This time around, his status report contribution will be rather short. With the 0.62 update, we have introduced many changes to the world lighting configuration. With the upcoming 0.63 update, we have made additional changes to address overall brightness during daytime, dawn and dusk transition brightness issues, improved nighttime and star readability. Please note the following comparison pictures 0.62 versus 0.63 light config are work in progress and do not represent the final state. It should also be noted that both pictures were taken on 0.63, which compared to 0.63 also contains a number of color improvements to environment assets, grass, vegetation, and artificial objects. As we can see on the night shot, stars are a lot more visible in 0.63, of course subject to change. And in the daytime shot, we can also see that visibility is greatly improved. Looks like some really nice improvements there from Adam, and I do like looking up at the night sky in DayZ. And last but not least, let's check out some awesome sound design from Philip. For the last couple of weeks, we have been busy with ambient sounds. Though we're not finished yet, we've made some progress. Ambient sounds are more dynamic now and react to weather changes and location changes. We've also made progress with positional environment sounds. Now you can hear birds and insects coming from trees and bushes, the rustle of leaves in the wind above your head, metal squeaks and creaks coming from old buildings, roofs, and much more. I'll leave you with a little clip of the ambient sounds for 0.63. Of course, again, links in the description below to the full video. And of course, never forget to check out the full community spotlight down the bottom of the status report. Some really good content there from some awesome community content creators. But first, there is a little bit of a Q&A, so let's have a read. Would the cost of DayZ servers be reduced with the beta release? Yes, in the future, anyone will be able to host their own servers with their own terms. As we want to release the DayZ server files with beta, maybe not right away with the first beta build, but definitely at some point during beta. Additionally, we want to provide a Linux version of the DayZ server files, and that should further cut the cost of running a DayZ server. While we don't have direct control over the pricing offered by our selected server providers at the moment, the Linux server files should also lead to noticeable cost reductions with these providers. There are more questions, go check them out yourselves, there's some pretty good information, but what I will leave you with to finish off this status report highlight is Beatty playing DayZ on the Xbox One. And that is all for this status report highlight for the 27th of February, 2018. I hope you enjoyed. Very juicy and lots of information and footage this week. Let's discuss 0.63 and this week's status report in the comment section below. Feel free to join our Discord, follow me on Twitter for all updates, and don't forget to catch me live on Twitch, where we're always having discussions about 0.63, DayZ's future, and much more. Remember to hit that like button, thank you for subscribing, and I'll see you peeps next time.